So what's up, guys? This is Sean Garrett here, representing
wrestling
mindset. In sports, we talk about a lot of things: your diet, your exercise, what you're doing, how you're lifting, how many times a day you're lifting, what you're eating, how you can get the exact calories, the right protein, the right recovery drinks, the right supplements, the right vitamins, and making sure that your body's feeling good for competition, for practice, and for just basic everyday living. But we don't often talk about the mind. The mind.
The mind is a terrible thing to waste.
It's actually your thinking that drives your action. So I remember I came to a point in my life where my coaches told me, hey, you can do this, you can be a national champion. We believe in you, we know, we see it in you, we see how hard you work, we see the talent that you have, we see the ability that you have to learn. It was something I was like, okay, for sure. You guys believe it, I'm gonna believe it. And here's the thing, is that it's hard to force yourself to believe something that you may or may not actually believe. And what I mean by that is this. I can tell myself over and over again, because my parents told me, or because my coach told me, that I'm gonna be a champion, I'm gonna be a state champion, I'm gonna be a national champion. If I'm only saying it because they told me to say it, or because it's been drilled so much into my mind to say it, I'm gonna have a hard time actually believing it for myself. Here's the thing, is that you actually have to believe things for yourself. So it's amazing if mom and dad think that I can do it. It's amazing if my coaches think that I can do it, if my friends think I can do it. It really doesn't matter how long you've been wrestling, how much time you're putting in. What matters is what you believe. And not only what you believe, but what you believe about yourself. Not what others believe about you. Because others might believe a lot of things about you, but you may not believe what they believe, and in the same way. I actually had a post recently on Instagram that talked about how exponential growth happens when no one is watching. When we are alone, we face every statement, every thought, every word spoken by us or spoken by others. In isolation, we come face to face with who we really are and decide if we're happy with what we see. And we have to decide at that moment in time if what we see is what we want. And if it's not something that we want, we have to change something in order to be where we want to be. Really, wrestling mindset is about having the right perspective. It's about viewing things the right way. Viewing situations, circumstances, hardships, training, competition, and compiling all these things and seeing it in the right way. Daily, I would walk into the wrestling room at Cornell University, and I remember driving with Gabe Dean, and he was like, man, we had that pit in our stomach, like, we know that we're gonna break ourselves today. Oh man, today's gonna be a hard day. You ready to go? Yeah, I'm ready to go. All right, you know, if you need anything, you look over me, I'll look over at you, and we got each other. Even on the hard days, it was fun for us. Our perception going into this practice was we're going to have fun no matter what. And nobody else can impose on me something that I'm not already imposing on myself. And so here's the thing, is that you can make anything as hard as you want to, or you make anything as easy as you want to. And we think oftentimes that it's the coaches or it's our parents or whoever who's dictating to us how hard things are. You don't have to allow other people to control how hard things are for you. You should be able to control how hard things are for you. And if you get to a point where you say to yourself, you know what, I don't want anybody pushing me more than I'm gonna push myself. When you get to that point, I think that's when there's a freedom that comes in every practice, and there's a freedom that comes in every competition, because you know no one is gonna get you more tired than you can get yourself. And when you realize that you're free from other people, then you know for yourself, the person I'm truly wrestling against is myself. I mean, the reality is first, your greatest enemy is not your coach. The greatest enemy is not fatigue. Your greatest enemy is not weight cutting. It's not competition. It's not fear. It's not anxiety. Your greatest enemy is actually yourself. The way you think, it's the way you process, it's the way you perceive things, it's the way that you understand yourself and the world around you. If you don't have the right perspective, you're really gonna miss out on the fullness of your own potential. We have to get the right perspective. Wrestling mindset is completely dedicated to helping you get the right perspective that you need. Wrestling mindset pairs you up with another coach who has been trained to understand and facilitate discussion with their athlete. And essentially, it's about understanding how we think. At the end of the day, your mind and how you believe makes up, I don't know, anywhere from 80 to 90% of your champion ability. I'm gonna say that again. Your mind, your thought process, your understanding, your perspective actually makes up 80 to 90% of your training. But so little time is focused and directed to specifically understanding how to train your mind to think about practice and competition. Here's how wrestling mindset became big for me. So I'd always had a pretty good mind about a lot of things. I had grown up, I started wrestling when I was in eighth grade, my freshman year to my senior year of high school. I had great coaches who taught me basic things, how to be as a person, not to be, you know, overzealous and not to be cocky and how not to be, you know, kind of in people's faces, because nobody likes people like that or whatever. The basic point that they showed me was be humble. And for me, that was like a very big thing in my mind. That was like, you know what? And everything I do, like especially when I'm wrestling, like I have to give the glory to God and I have to be humble about what I'm doing. That's a great key advice, and that's a great advice if that's what you're teaching your kids and if that's what you're teaching your athletes. Here's the thing that it can get kind of twisted, and here's where it got twisted for me. Because for me, being humble meant making sure that other people saw that I was humble. It meant that the things that I said and things that I did on the mat backed up the idea and the facade of what humility was. And so essentially, every time I would go out there and wrestle on the mat, I would be thinking to myself, okay, make sure I don't beat this kid by that much. Make sure I don't embarrass this kid. Make sure I don't do this to this kid. And I was thinking about how other people's perceptions would affect me. What that ended up doing for me in the long run, and it was a mentality that I did have to break off. I was actually suppressing the greatness that was inside of me because I was so afraid of how other people perceived me to be. Trying to get people to perceive me as something, I actually suppressed myself and the greatness that was already put inside of me. Here's how it affected me in college, and here's how it affected me like throughout the rest of my training. I remember moments of training where I'm wrestling hard and even just drilling. And coaches had to be on me and like, Nishan, why are you so upset right now? And I'd be so frustrated and so angry if I didn't get everything perfect. Why? Because I thought that if I didn't get this perfect, then that means that I'm not good enough. If I didn't get this takedown, I'm not good enough. That if I didn't do this, then I'm not a champion. If I don't get this double leg down, then I'm not gonna be able to take people down. It really frustrated me because every single time I trained, I put myself in that national champion position. I put myself in the semifinals. I put myself in the quarterfinals. And I trained my mind to think about these big moments in time. I was thinking that it was what I did that defined who I was. So wrestling mindset does just that. Hello? Hey, Mom.
What's going on with you?
Just chilling.
Yeah?
They work with teams and they work with one-on-one for individuals so that you can get your mind right. Whatever sport you're doing, especially obviously the sport of wrestling, getting your mind right for wrestling is essential, and it's one of the primary things that I feel it's what makes all the difference. It's the champion type mindset. So listen, if it's something that you've been struggling with, mindset, whether it's in practice, whether it's in competition, it's hard to sleep at night because of that loss that you had, you feel the burden of expectation or pressure, feeling not good enough, feeling like you're not matching up with the training, then it's probably something that you should try out and probably something that you should get invested in. So again, this is Wrestling Mindset. And if you go to WrestlingMindset.com, you can sign up for a free trial. And it's gonna be amazing, it's gonna be awesome. And I'd love to see how it goes. I'll see you guys next week. Thank you so much for listening. Sean out.
Mind is a terrible thing to waste.